Peace and blessings, everyone. This is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist, and I'm doing a supplemental video for the one that I did at Africans Sell Africans into Slavery. And I'm basically really responding to Civil Dem 1, because you hit my page twice with the same statement, just worded different, or the same request, just worded different. But first, I want to, you know, say to you why I began this particular line of conversation. And I really, really was trying to understand disunity amongst black people, or distrust amongst black people. And so why we just couldn't seem to trust each other, or why we just couldn't seem to get it together. Why, why we have this whole disunity, as we always talk about, we need to be unified, we need to unify, we need to, you know, come together and all that kind of shit like that. So that's what began me on my quest to understanding, or trying to understand, you know, why black people cannot unify. And so what I discovered was that there's never been unity across what we would consider a black nation. Because for the most part, we've been basically tribal or ethnically based, you know, aligned with one another. And then when it came to the slave trade, I also realized that there was distrust prior to the Europeans' arrival in Africa, because war generally breeds distrust. So you cannot trust someone who's warring on you, whether they look like you or not, you know. And despite the fact of whether you're using powerful weapons and you just got spears and shit, y'all still fighting. So that breeds distrust in itself. So, you know, my conclusion is that after I, you know, brought to the forefront the conversation about, you know, we are so focused on the Europeans selling other Africans, and I know damn well that, you know, using the analogy of your home, ain't nobody going to come up in your house without your permission, unless they're breaking in. And if you're there, I'm quite sure that you will be able, you know, to do something about that, right? That it'll be continued. They just have to literally kill your ass, right? So when I look at the all these slave trades, because there were four major slave trades, is that there had to be collusion from within, with those from within. You know, and regardless as to whether they were, you know, kin or enemies that you captured in war, or people that were sold off because of crimes they committed against others in the village or the group or whatever, the fact is that it couldn't have happened without help from inside. You know, Africans had to be involved in the slave trade. Bottom line, I mean, that's, but we don't want to admit that. And that, to me, is one of the things that stymie our unity, is that we're constantly focusing on the outside. But to understand the disunity and the distrust, or the mistrust, that we have from within has a far, far more historical basis. And so, and this is why, you know, people like Marcus Garvey, Kwame Nkrumah, all of them were calling for the unity of Africa, because they understood why Africans were disunified, And I don't even think, you know, just reading stuff from them, their analysis was based on the invasion of the European into Africa, but I'm talking about prior to the invasion of the European. Why were they fighting in the first place, the African people? So there had to be some discord as to why they were fighting in the first place, which would give the European the ability to come in and offer, you know, better weaponry to fight their enemy. Not only that, the Europeans also brought, you know, certain items that were that were wanted by those in power, not necessarily the masses of the people, but those in power, you know, liquor being the main one of them. So, you know, I think that my whole goal was not to do the blame game, because I'm not into the blame game. I'm into the truth game. And so to try to understand this unity and the fact that, you know, perhaps we're reaching for something that we cannot attain because of our various different mindsets. And even though, you know, on the continent it was ethnically based, where here it's religiously based, it has all other kind of nuances that cause us to have differences with one another, differences so much that we lose focus on the greater good for the people at large, for the entire group of people. So that's basically why I, you know, did the African Selling Africans. And I also did a video about whites being brought into slavery as well. And you would find, I guess, if it wasn't the black against white thing, it would probably be something else. And I'm trying to, you know, determine as to whether that's some kind of human characteristic or something. Is that part of our humanity? You know what I'm saying? That's basically why I did that. It wasn't to, you know, point blame at the Africans and say, well, you know, if it wasn't for the Africans, we wouldn't gotten enslaved. Well, I mean, that's true to a point, but that wasn't the whole goal. The goal was, in the beginning, is to understand why we have this unity, and based on the fact that Africans sold Africans, we still selling each other out. You know what I'm saying? The game has not changed. That's my point, is that the game has not changed of selling each other out. We have no allegiance based on skin color even today. We'll sell each other out at the drop of a hat. You know it, and I know it. So that's just the reality, and bringing that reality to the fore, I think is important for us of like minds who understand the power in unity, that, you know, we just keep on our tread, you know, on our path, you know, to work with one another and help one another, those who deserve it, you know, those who we have an alignment with, those who we have a moralistic value, we share the same moralistic values with each other. I think that those of us who do that, you know, in understanding the history, we understand exactly where it all stems from, and the fact that, you know, this total unity of black people is something we're not going to have. And that's just a historical base, just based on the fact that Africans sold Africans into slavery, you know, bartered them just like they would barter anything else. The thing that I would say, though, and I would repeat this, is that Africans did not build empires based on slavery like Europeans have. You know, they have not built civilizations based on slavery like Europeans have. They have not accumulated wealth based on slavery like Europeans have. They did not destroy or try to dehumanize the human like Europeans had to justify their actions against those humans. So there's a big difference in the process, I would say. But I would stand to say that the process wouldn't have been so massive had it not been assisted from within. That's my point. So yes, I do agree that there were some who, as you say, there were some who let some slaves escape, you know, just like niggas today. They have fate, like in office, politicians in office, they help their friends and their cronies and their relatives and, you know, you take advantage of certain statutes and laws and things like that. I mean, it's the same thing. You know, it's kind of like black slave owners actually bought family members, you know what I'm saying? But then there were some who actually owned slaves. Let's just keep it real. And treated them like slaves, okay? So, you know, we just have to understand the dynamics of humanity. You know, humanity is dual. It's a dual it's dual. You know, to use terms like good and evil, you know, it's kind of like yin and yang, good and evil. I know we got two sides of ourselves that we constantly battle. You know, what we know is right. Well, what is right? Well, right is what don't hurt. Okay, that's right. All right. What is wrong? Wrong is what hurts. Bottom line. Okay, that's, you know, and that's for each person to determine what hurts and what doesn't hurt. You know what I'm saying? So if it hurts you, don't you think it'll hurt someone else? You know, if you like it, don't you think somebody else might like it? You know what I'm saying? So I guess because we have these things, well, who's to say who's right and wrong? Well, you can determine what's right and wrong. I mean, we're not stupid. You know, human beings aren't stupid. They do know, but we have this uncanny ability to be able to differentiate. You know what I'm saying? At any given moment, you know, we can justify our behavior when we know in our hearts that it's causing harm to somebody. We can still justify it. You know what I'm saying? So that's basically why I did those videos, is because I understood after I had done, you know, just a little, not even a whole lot of damn research, just a little bit of research and common sense, that this whole thing about unity and black people coming together, it ain't gonna happen. It's gonna always be groups of black people that come together and live by a certain standard. And I wish I had a whole state of black people that had the same morals and values that I did. Not all of us thinking alike, but all of us having the same understanding of our morality, our do's and don'ts in the culture. You know, because thoughts bring new ideas and things like that, but there is a underlying way that we would treat one another and do business with one another and things like that. So I would like to just have a state of those, and we leave all the rest, and we protect that state, and we protect our interests together. And you know, that's the utopia that I'm looking for. As far as all black people coming together, that's not gonna happen, not as far as I can see. You know, so I'm not trying to live that dream anymore. I was there with the, oh, we are going to be unity, we need unity. No. I've seen the way we treat each other. Irregardless to what the history or what the past has enlightened us with, we still will dog each other out. That's just, you know, how it's been. So that's basically what the whole idea behind the videos was about. I hope now you understand. And that it was not to place the total blame of the condition of black people on black people, but to understand that there is no thing as unity amongst black people. That was the whole idea, and it's not going to be any, you know, in total. That's what I was trying to get across. So I hope you got it. I hope you understand it. And if I need to clarify it any more for you, I don't think I can. I think that's about as clear as I can get it. And if you don't understand that, then I can't go no further, all right? Okay, everybody.